So here, third one is of many to one relation. So here, when we consider the relation as R from A into B, so here many to one is said to be called as, many to one relation is said to be called as if and only if the two or more elements of set A are having the relationship with the one and only one element of set B, then such a type of relation is said to be called as many to one relation. So here a relation, when we consider by means of capital R, which is from A into B, is said to be many to one relation if and only if two or more elements of set A are related, or in other words are having the relationship with, are related to one element of set B. That means two or more elements of set A must have the relationship with the one and only one element of set B, then such a type of relation is said to be called as many to one relation. So here let us illustrate by means of one example. So under this example, so we are going to consider the set A elements as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 elements of set A, and the set B elements are of P, Q. Then now here this is of set A and this is the set B. So here set A elements are of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and set B elements are of only 2, they are of P and Q, but the relation R is from A into B. So relation R, but here as per the condition that is many to one, so more than 2, so 2 or more elements of set A must have the relationship with only one and only one element. So here 2 elements, 1 comma 2, so 1 and 2 elements are having the relationship with, so here one element that is P. So 1 comma P, image of 1 is of P, and as well as the image of 2 is also of P. Image of 3 is Q, then now image of 4 is also of Q, and image of 5 is also of Q. So here 2 elements or more than 2 elements, that are here there are of 3, 2 or more than 3, so 2 or more than 2, that is 3 elements of set A are having the relationship with only one and only one element. So here 2 elements, 1 comma 2 is having only one relationship with only one element P. So here 3 elements, 3, 4, 5 are having the relationship with only one element, that is Q. So therefore this relation will come under the many to one, that is many to one relation. So here relation is given by means of 1 comma P, the first ordered pair, and 2 comma P, the next ordered pair, 3 comma Q, 4 comma Q, and as well as 5 comma Q are the remaining ordered pairs or the elements of the relation that is R from A into B, which is nothing but which come under the many to one relation. Then now let us go for the fourth one, that is the last one. So your fourth one is of many to many relation. So under this relation, when we consider a relation R from A into B, then many to many relation is said to be a relation if and only if two or more than two elements of set A must be related with two or more than two elements of set B, then only it will come under the many to many relation. So here if a relation R from A into B or in other words, so here a relation R from A into B is said to be many to many relation if and only if two or more elements of set A are related to two or more elements of set B. So then such a type of relation is said to be called as many to many relation. So here let us illustrate by means of one example. So in this relation, so here two or more than two elements of set A must have the relationship with the two or more than two elements of set B. Then such a type of relation is said to be called as many to many relation. So here illustration. So under this illustration, we are going to consider, so here set A elements as 1, 2, 3, and set B elements as 4, 5, 6. So here this is the first set and this is the second set. The first set is represented by means of A and the second set by means of B. The elements, the function, the relation is from, relation R is from A into B. So here the relation is from, so here the elements of A are of 1, 2, 3, the elements of set B are of 4, 5, 6. But as per the condition or as per the rule of the many to many relation, so here two or more than two elements of this particular set A must have the relationship with two or more than two elements of set B. So here the relation is in this manner. So here 1, 4, 5, 6. So element 1 of set A is having 3 images. Similarly, element 2 is also having the 3 images, 2, 4, 5, and 2, 6. Similarly, element 3 of set A is having the 3 images, that is 3, 4, 5, and 6. So here from this it is concluded that, say here 2 or more than 2 elements of set A are having 2 or more than 2 elements of set B, the relations. So here the relation is given by means of 1, 4 as the first ordered pair, 1, 5, 1, 6, and the next ordered pairs are of 2, 4, 2, 5, and then 2, 6, and the next three ordered pairs are of 3, 4, 3, 5, 3, 6. So here two or more than two elements of set A are having the relationships with the two or more than two elements of set B. So therefore the relation R will come under the many to many relation.